Yarns from the South.
I know, it has been a long time between drinks.
Yeah. Are we really real? Are we real?
No, we are. Look, oh, yeah. Pinch. Oh, I'm still here.
Oh.
It's just been a busy, busy time of year. And, things have got a bit in the way, but we managed to get back here. For those of you who are just tuning in, you're probably thinking, what on earth are these ladies on about?
Yeah.
So my name's Vanessa.
And I'm Sue.
And we are, oh, we've already said that.
We've said who we are.
Yeah, let's wrap this up. We are a knitting and crafting podcast.
Yeah, coming to you from New Zealand. We are in Invercargill at the very bottom of the South Island. And this is episode 10.
Wow, 10. And this has been about a year, hasn't it?
Yeah, it was a year last October, but we got to October and then just stopped. So
did we even do one in October?
No, we didn't even do another mystery one.
We had lots of plans. We really did. But none of them came to fruition.
No.
I think it's okay. We're here now.
I got to the end of the year like crawling, like at some kind of like rabid turtle.
Rabid turtle.
Rabid.
Rabid.
Yeah.
Right.
Like a turtle with rabies.
Okay. yes, it was a bit of a hard slog.
Yeah. Yeah.
I feel like we're waffling.
We are, but that's what we're good at.
Yeah, very good.
Anyway, cool. So we hope you're well wherever you are. We know we're still in a global pandemic. Mm. So I know things will be tough for some of you. So we hope this brings a little bit of cheer to you. So we've got a few things. We're going to go through our usuals.
Yeah.
And plus we're going to talk giveaways, but that's at the end, so you need to keep on watching. Mm-hmm. Yeah, cool.
Right, so yeah, it's been so long. When did we podcast last? The last time you saw us, we were still in lockdown, so we podcast from our own homes, didn't
we? Yeah, so we did a Zoomy one. Yeah.
So now, obviously, we're out of lockdown, thankfully.
Foxy's back.
Mr. Foxy's back. So I know I've done a lot more knitting than what I'm going to show you, but I could not for the life of me find much of what I've finished. Should we do finished objects first?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. It'll be quick for me.
Right. Okay. So, I have finished a few more things, but I couldn't find them. Some of them were gift knits. Some of them were baby knits and all that kind of thing. The last thing that came off my needles. Oh, surprise!
Oh,
a pair of socks.
Oh, yeah. They're nice.
I do love them. Good old pair of socks. They're just the usual vanilla sock pattern that I sort of make up for my own foot. And the yarn is some of Hannah from Maniatoto Yarns. Maniatoto Wool. I should know this. Wool. Her sock base. Yeah. And I can't remember I think it's Speckled Riverstone is the colourway.
That's really nice.
Delicious. Yeah, I love it.
That's really nice.
And you got to remember, it is summer here, down here in the southern hemisphere. So, you know, you lose your knitting. I lose my knitting mojo. We have had such hot, ridiculous weather.
Really hot
down
here.
It has been 28, 29 degrees, which we don't usually get that hot.
No,
and I don't like it that hot. I was in such a grump the last few days because it's been too hot. Anyway, but good old dishcloths. Face cloths. Yeah.
Oh, face.
Yeah, just because they're cotton, so it's not too, you know, hot, and it's light and easy. What I've done for these patterns is I have this book. I don't know. Hopefully you're seeing that the right way around.
Is that your book?
Yeah, it's my book.
I've not seen that before.
Oh, yeah. I've had this one for a while.
I'd like to borrow that, please.
Go on, then. Up, down, all around stitch dictionary. So it's really cool. It's got all of these different pattern,
I didn't know you had this.
Oh, my goodness. Hello. How long have we known each other?
Oh, my God.
I've still got secrets.
That's what keeps our relationship fresh.
That's right.
Ooh, I love that.
So what's great about this book is that it gives you the, it's all in the title. It gives you the instructions for not only for it in the flat, like that certain stitch repeat pattern, but it'll also do it in the round. And it's broken up into different sections, so there's lace and cable and texture and all that kind of thing. And at the back of each section, there's like a recipe, if you like, for a different garment. So it basically just gives you the instructions on how to build a sweater, but then you can put your own pattern, you know, the like a lace pattern or a cable pattern or whatever into it. So yeah, very cool. So I just used that book and did a couple of different pattern. Oh, I can't remember what that's called. What is that called? Pattern.
I've no idea what you're trying to say.
It's gonna be like that, folks. Sorry, that's okay. It's the end of the day, so
buckle in.
Hold on tight. I know one of our fellow knitters. This is how she taught herself how to knit. Sinead Perkins, I see you over there. She just got I don't know where she was getting her stitch patterns from, but it must have been some sort of book. And she, rather than just knitting a boring old scarf or whatever, she just knit up squares of all these different patterns, and it taught her increases, decreases, you know, all the different, which is such a great way of learning it all. So anyway, that was my excitement last week, finishing up those sorts of things. But that's really it for my finished objects. I know I've got a few more socks, but I couldn't find them. So, and they were gifts. Anyway, over to you.
Yeah, so I'll be quick. Not got anything.
Got nothing.
There we go, nothing.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because it has been some time.
Because I've been working on
I don't know what that is.
Oh, well, I'll show you in a minute.
We're finding out.
So. I'll show you in a minute.
I'm trying to look over here. What is it? Okay.
Yeah, so now I don't have anything finished.
Segues into works in progress. What's your works in progress?
Hi. So I think cast your mind back to our last episode, and we were talking about doing a knit along, weren't we?
Oh, yes.
So we were really excited.
We were so fresh-faced and excited and youthful. And
couldn't wait to do the knit along with Stephen West, doing the Shawlography. And, oh, it was so exciting. Yes. And, oh, I can't wait, all my colourways. And I'm exactly where I thought it would be.
3 months later.
3 months later. I haven't picked it up in a month.
Okay, go on then.
I'm happy with it.
It's taking some time.
It's been good. And if you're still doing it, you would have bloody seen it by now if you haven't.
Surely,
you've been living in a cave.
But if you haven't, look away now.
You look away now. Mm. Oh, spoiler. And I think I'm halfway through.
I'm halfway through a thingy.
I'm not even sure. So. You can't get the staff.
Podcasting.
Yeah,
it's gone downhill.
Gone downhill. Yeah, sorry. So, so I can't even hold it out.
Oh, it's looking beautiful though.
Yeah, it's kind of rainbowy.
Yeah. Which section are you into now?
I'm not even on the third one yet. I'm still getting to the third one. So, those of you who have done the Shawlography this year will know where I'm at. But I'm just after the bobbles. It's great, like loads of texture, love Stephen West.
My goodness, he's so
And I think
delicious.
For me, when I first opened up the first clue and I saw what he was asking us to do, I immediately just, and I've knitted for 14 years, so it's not like, and immediately saw what he was asking us to do and I went, I can't fucking do that.
Has been a good challenge for
I loved his tutorials. It just went, I just loved, don't stress, Just say yes.
Just say yes. Don't stress.
And love it when he's just like, and if you've got too many, just decrease. Or if you haven't got enough, just increase. Yeah. And I just love that because I would do that anyway, but also, I made a mistake.
But he gives you that permission.
Yeah.
Which makes you feel like, I do know what I'm doing. It's okay. I'm not a dumb knitter.
No. And his tutorials are really good. I just found at the end of last year, I got to a point where my brain just needed something that just didn't require me to sit down on YouTube and learn it. Once you learned the stitch, it was fine. You could go for how many rows. But, So I've still got a bit to go.
Right though,
but I think I will pick it up. I'm not gonna do something else, I think then I'll probably pick it up, but yeah. But
you reminded me, I forgot that I even had this. Oh, I don't know what I've been working on. Oh, that's right.
Well, yeah, because this was and I think I've learned I'm maybe not a knit along person.
It's all learning,
but that's
it?
Okay,
yeah.
I don't see me doing
you're not gonna do this year's one?
No. Yeah, I found myself getting a little bit stressed that I wasn't keeping up. And then I thought, oh, fuck it.
Yeah.
So, and then I've just been in the naughty corner. So, but I know, like, other people, I've seen other people on Instagram, they've only just finished.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
And what have you, so.
I'm sure I've heard of people only just finishing the one from 2020, so.
Yeah, right.
You follow your own.
Yeah. And I know, and he also said, embrace your pace, it's not a race.
That's the other one, yeah.
But when you keep seeing everyone's pictures.
Oh, some people were like, it felt like they were finished before the, you know.
Our mate Jodie, she finished it a week after.
Yeah. I kept good pace for a time, and then I completely forgot to bring mine along, but I'm up to the last section. I think I've done like one row of the last section. And I lost my mojo, guys. I lost my mojo. I've sort of, socks have been the only thing I've really been
mojo.
At. Where are you?
Mojo.
Where are you,
mojo?
I loved Stephen's tutorials and the way he sort of guides you through it. And I love each different section and the challenge that it gave you, but I don't know. I think you're right. Just that time of year, and I had a lot of things going on, and yeah, just that brain power wasn't at the best, the optimal. Yeah. I think it'll be cool though once you've finished it.
Yeah, I don't see myself wearing it, but I do see it. It goes with my colour scheme in my house. So
you could pop it over you.
Yeah, if I put it on the chair, I thought.
Yeah. Nice.
But it's been a positive experience, but just needed a wee break.
Yeah.
A wee break. So, So I will pick it back up again at some point. But happy with the colourways, and the colourway was from Nana Cindy.
That's right.
Yeah.
Have you got anything else on your needles?
I picked up, what did I pick up?
Socks.
The anti-soccer over here. She picked up a pair of socks. Oh, so I'm making my first pair of socks for my husband.
Oh, lucky.
For Jim. Jim always wears black socks, doesn't wear a lot of knits in general because he wears t-shirts, he's Scottish and made of a lot of hair. So what am I making him? Nice and subtle. I'm making him some Revolution Designs. This one here. Liquor Shawl Sorts or Nemo, depending on which. So yes, nice and subtle for Jim. Yeah. But he's been into orange recently.
Well, there you go.
So
that's pretty orange.
Yeah. So nearly finished. I'm just about to do
the toe
decrease.
Oh, you're so close.
But what actually I am using, which is probably in acquisitions, is if you can see that.
Really cool.
So these are by Addy, and these are the Crazy Trio.
That's right.
So, especially for socks, I think. And so you have three needles, and they're
bendy.
So basically double point, but they're bendy. And I love them, and they're brilliant for socks.
Mm.
So basically, it's like a combination of...
circular.
Circular.
Double pointed.
Yeah, because I prefer double pointed when I'm doing... and also they're metal, so they're not risk of breaking. So I actually kind of started on double pointed, bought these and then swapped, and then have carried on these. So yeah, so really do awesome. Recommend them.
They're looking good.
Yeah, so nearly there. Mm.
Yep.
So nice and, but no, Jim seems pleased with them. I have. Awesome. I buggered up how many stitches I casted on, so that one's slightly bigger than that one, but it'll be fine. Mm. So yeah.
Stephen Weiss says it's fine, so it's fine.
It'll be fine.
Yeah.
Jim, I'm sure it'll fit Jim. So yeah. So that's I'm just desperate to finish.
Sorry guys, this is gonna be a bit of a boring episode because do you wanna see my works in progress?
Oh, I wonder what this will be, everybody. Oh, 10 points.
Oh, look at this.
It's a sock.
Oh,
it's a sock.
I'm just on the heel.
I do love that colourway, though.
I love it. It is. This is Rainy Day Yarns.
Oh, I could
eat
that.
And this is their navel gazing.
Oh, my God. I could eat that up.
I know. I love it. And this is. I got this from when we were in Christchurch at the
Wool Fest.
Feast. One of those ones. Last year in June. So yeah, I'm really happy with that.
Yeah, I love that.
But that's I mean, I know there's other things on my needles, but they're all in naughty corners. I'll find them one day.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. That was quick.
There we go.
What have you been watching? Reading Corner?
Acquisitions.
Oh, I don't even know.
I had a request from my cousin John.
Hi. And Lydia.
And that we need to do the jingle for Reading Corner when it's time.
Okay. But we won't do that yet.
No, because it's not time.
Okay.
Hold on to that.
Acquisitions.
You can go.
All right. I actually...
probably got more than I've actually brought, to be honest.
I know. I didn't bring everything that I've gotten in the last wee while because I couldn't remember.
We had Christmas.
Speaking about Christmas, I got the Vintage Pearls Christmas Club again this year, which I just love. I got the Art Deco one, and so. This is gorgeous superstar.
And they're yummy.
Yarn. 70% Polworth, 20% Tussa Silk, and 10% Black New Zealand Merino.
Lovely.
Yeah, so yummy. Scrumptious. So we got these, and we got some lovely little tags.
Nice.
I think... these are little stickers.
That's of the inspiration of the...
So that...
Because you don't know what you're going to get. No.
So those two pictures, I think it was just those two pictures, were the inspiration behind the colourways. These tags, they say, this took a lot of time. Do not put it in your dryer. Gentle hand wash in lukewarm water, lay flat to dry. So, that will be very cool to be able to put on garments that I give away. To be fair, I don't really give away a lot of big garments. Socks if people are lucky. But that was super, and some yummy fudge as well. Okay, that was very nice to open on Christmas morning.
Gorgeous.
That's pretty much it for me. I know I did get some other bits and pieces, but I didn't bring them. So. Okay. Cool. Okay. See you soon.
Okay. All right. Well, I also did the.
Sorry, that was totes me. Totes bed. Oh dear.
How unprofessional. Anyone would think we just do this as a hobby.
Anyone would think we don't get paid for this.
Yeah. Well, now she's moving it again.
No, I just...
So I also did the Yarny Club. I've not done one before. Mm.
Still got your fudge.
Yeah.
Like, she won't do by the end of the night.
I can't remember what colourway I got.
Astronomy?
Yeah, we'll go with that. Yeah. So... So I've got the Superstar Sports Edition, and the colour is Trouble.
Sure.
I'm going to say that. That sounds quite French. It's got a T in it. So duvet and bouquet. Mm. Trouble.
Nice.
Where? And so this is kind of one of the, that was the picture that was inspiring. So yeah, so I'm not sure I'm gonna, and I got some nice little tags. And these tags have got the date, pattern, yarn, needle size, size before blocking and after blocking, and notes. Yeah, I do. And I've got some. You can have it if you want it.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you not like fudge?
I'm doing Weight Watchers again.
Oh, who does this? Okay, thank you.
Yeah, so I'm not sure I'm going to do those. I had seen some really nice mittens, so I might.
Yeah, that would look cool.
Yeah. Yeah, so what is this? This is 70% Polworth. Oh, 20% tussock silk and 10% black. Oh, yeah, same with your black.
So that's the sports weight, so slightly thicker than...
that one. Yeah, so that's lovely. And I really... enjoyed doing the yarn club because it's just a surprise. Yes. And you're just putting your faith in into the diet.
And she's amazing.
Yeah, and I've bought... I was lucky enough to... Have I won? No. Yeah.
Was that from here?
No.
Anyway,
I've bought things from Morag and our friend Jodie knows Morag quite well, so so that was kind of cool. And then so some purchases of yarn. Now there's a bit of a theme going. I'll wait and see if you notice the theme, eh? Where will we go with this? Oh yeah, so I went up north, up to Lee, and to see a good friend of mine, Cheryl, and her partner Neil. And as her Christmas present, she said she was going to buy me some yarn. And she lives very close to the knitting truck, which is run by Anne, and she is up near Matakana. And been there before, and so she's got outside, has this like mini home that's kind of the knitting truck, and it's such a cool little place. So Cheryl bought me this little kit. So it's a pattern, and Anne does her own patterns. She's also online. We'll put the link in the description. So picked out, and then these are the colours. So I've got yellow and like an oatmeal-y colour. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so this is Outlaw, and it's 45% Polworth, 45% alpaca, 10% possum. Feels really yummy. So
I don't know which way you want, but how about you just look at the yummy.
Yeah. Ooh, that's lovely. Yeah. I'm loving that close up.
Yeah, and I love the wee halo that it has.
Yeah. So yeah, excited. And I think I might even make that next because I think it'll be a nice quick.
Ooh.
Yeah. So that's her deets. So yeah.
Cute.
Sweet. And then I went in and had a little look-see myself, and I bought this lovely yarn. Can you see that?
Yeah.
With the light. So this is Prosper sock base Dixie Chick.
Oh.
8020 merino nylon. So really like the speckle.
That is beautiful.
And, yeah. And Anne had done some. She had an example of a sock she made, and a quite a nice patterned sock. I don't know if I'm brave enough to do that, but yeah, so that's lovely. And then a couple of other ones. This is one by Revolution Designs. I've been given this recently.
makes me sound
funny. She is flash. So this is a nice yellow
Christmas present.
Yeah.
Is
really
anyone
like
spotting
it.
The theme yet?
I don't know. Have you noticed it? It's really subtle.
One more.
And oh, hello. Let's look at the theme. Yeah. So this is from our mate Hannah at Manitoto Wool. Gave her a handout with the old business and got paid in yarn. So this is. I'm not very good with knowing her different bases, but I think this is the Aran.
It's the Aran.
Yeah. And I couldn't tell you the colour.
I'm pretty sure she... Oh, is it Corfoy? Or is it... I'm not sure.
Not sure, but we can find out. Yeah. So, what colours do I like?
And look, you happen to be.
I know, and I'm wearing some yellow tonight. Yeah. So.
That's okay. That's cool.
So that's cool. And also, this, I know this isn't actually an indie dad, but this was just a pickup from good old Spotlight. But I was with my auntie, Auntie Claire. Hi, Auntie Claire.
Hi.
And she was saying that this is quite popular with her and her knitting crew for making socks. And I thought it might be a quite a nice contrast. Mm. So it's just a grey, but it's, and I got it up in the clearance, and it's, can't see the label. I think it's
Waikiwi,
yeah. Mm. And 55% merino. I can't clear anything else. But yeah. Mm. So I quite like the idea of
grey yellow.
Yeah.
Cool.
So yeah.
Lovely.
Yeah, there we go. Nice.
All right. Well, I've got a couple of things I wanted to talk about.
Oh. Okay.
How do you feel about that?
Okay. Tell me when it's Reading Corner, because I have to do the jingle.
I promise it won't take long. Okay. Because I just wanted to pay homage to, or like go back to a year ago when we podcast and we talked about, I think, New Year's resolutions or something like that. And I had said that I wanted to fill up my sock basket for the year. And guys, I just wanted to show.
Oh, look at that.
I did it. Well, pretty much. There's a couple of other socks that are missing because they're, you know, in the wash or whatever. But I feel really, when I looked at that this morning and I was like, I did do something last year.
Oh, isn't that beautiful?
I filled up my sock basket.
In fairness, you always have you're always knitting a sock.
Yeah, I know, right? So, oh, wow, how did that happen? It's like I don't even know. And because I don't know if I talked about, yeah, I did. I think we talked about, or I talked about this lovely little journal that Jodie, one of our knitting friends, made and gave to, I think, most of us on 2020, in Christmas 2020. And I use mine as a knitting journal, and I have put in...
oh, look at you.
Yeah, all the things that I had made. I really wanted to get... This is my husband, hello. And look, he's got some socks in here too.
Hello.
With the stripey.
Look at him looking off into the distance. I know, right? Look at all manly.
Oh, he's such a model. Oh, I'm going to tell him. It's going to be pissed. He's out there on the internet now.
He's a star.
This is where it begins, guys. So I did a wee tally up of all the different things that I made, and I've made 14 socks last year, pieces of socks. Not all of them for me, some of them for family.
Wow.
Lucky bastards, aren't they? Two garments, technically, because there's a third one that's, but it's not quite finished. Two hats and one blanket. So I know that's not like... I know people who have made like 12 garments, like full, you know, but, you know, I love that.
That's so good that you've written it down. I couldn't tell you what I made.
Well, here we go. So I'm going to try and keep that going for this year. Gosh, it's 2022 already. Yeah.
Whoa, I might do that.
See what happens.
Yeah. Oh, I'm inspired.
Here we go. Yeah.
Because I think you actually gave me a book that's actually... try those things in.
So
I do have one.
Go on.
Or a notepad or something.
I just realised, because I finished these this year, so that they can go towards this year.
They can go in. Wow. Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
I'll go you.
Oh, thanks. Thanks very much. Yeah.
Cool.
All right.
Is it time?
Oh, it is. Go on.
Reading corner.
That's for you, John. Going out for John.
That's for John. I'm not ready, you go first.
Okay, so looking at my notes, just
she's written it all down. I'm just gonna look.
I have been audiobook listening on Audible to a whole bunch of books.
Potentially we've listened to the same thing,
probably,
so it
could be a double up. There's a whole series of books by a author called Kate Hewitt. Sure, that's her name.
Yes, yeah. It is.
They are set in Willoughby Close, which is in the, I could never say that word,
Cotswolds
in England, and it's really lightweight. Oh my gosh, it's so lightweight, but it's and romance, and but not too romancy. And it's,
I really like
them. So, I love them. They're the classic girl goes to the country, like has to ends up in the countryside somehow for one reason or another, and it was all disillusioned with life, and then meets a guy and blah 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 blah. Not, yeah, it, but it's not too cheesy.
I'm no, yeah. I yeah. You tell me about them, and cause they're a little bit similar to the Knitting Vampire ones that we listened to. And I would start and listen to another book the other night. I couldn't cope with it. I had to go back to Kay.
They're perfect. Yeah. Perfect for mindless, can't sink into anything too deep. Yeah.
Lovely. And depending on what membership you have on Audible, they're free ones.
Yeah, that's yeah. right. Yeah. Or a bunch of them are free. Yeah,
yeah.
So that's mainly what I've been listening to. Mm. The last few days, my husband and I and the kids have been away at a looking after a friend's farm.
Like you do.
Like you do. But it's been so stinking hot that, like, the boys had fun. But I was so grumpy because it was so hot. And you had to sort of hide from the sun. So we did a lot of just being indoors hiding because it was too hot, and somehow one of the boys had heard me listening to the Vampire series, the Vampire Knitting Club series, one day, and he'd said, "Mom, can we listen to that again?" So I started them off on the first book, and it's a murder mystery, so there is a little bit of but it's not too gory. It's not gory at all.
No, it's a cozy murder.
It's a cozy murder. Mm. Yeah. And the boys loved it. They were like, I think it could have been this person because of the, you know, and they love the whole mystery of it all and trying to work out who it could have been. So we're on book two. I think we've just about finished book two. And they're the ones who are like, Mum, can we listen to the book again? So
that's so cool.
That is so cool.
That's so cool.
And oh my gosh, it's kept them peaceful and quiet. And they just sit there and listen and listen. And I love
that's
it.
That's so cool.
Yeah, even Mark's been like, oh, okay, let's put it on. So those two things. And then I've also been watching / listening to The Witcher, which is a book series, and it's a gaming series, and now it's a movie, Netflix series. I initially watched that last year and I was like, nah, it's okay. It's not... yeah, you know, there's a certain thing about it that's not much. But then I watched it again this year and I thought, actually, it's all right. It's a bit of all right. So, yeah, that's me. That's nice. What I've been watching. That's what I've been nice. Listening. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I've been reading, listening to the same things. So, watching-wise, combination of things, really. Watched... some Harry Potters.
Okay.
Cool. Yep. Over the Christmas period. And oh my God, I love Harry Potter. Oh, because I watched the Harry Potter reunion.
Oh, yes, yeah, same.
Yeah. Oh, I love that.
Can you believe it's been that long? My goodness.
I was in tears. Oh. I was in tears when they filmed. I was watching it with Jim. I was like, it's just a really important, it's really important series. It's like so important. It's like really helped me. Yeah. I swear I would one day write a book about Harry Potter helped me through depression. Wow. So, yeah. Aww, I really, beautiful. Yeah. And I was a late bloomer. I was a late bloomer and I didn't read my audio books because I don't have enough concentration to read. But yeah, oh, I just love them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so there we go. And some things I've been watching. I watched a really good thing on Netflix called Stay Close, which is an 8-part series with some really good actors in it. And I can't really remember Jimmy Nesbitt, but very good.
Mm-hmm.
Recommend that. You're going to ask me what the storyline is, and...
No, but if you say no, it's good.
It's good. No, is really, really good.
Is it a mystery type thing?
Yeah. Yeah, totally. Yeah, really good. And then we've been watching some stuff on demand. Just started watching something. It's particularly miserable. Oh no, what we watched Guilt. That was really good. The second series of Guilt. Okay. Oh, I think I've mentioned that to you before. Mm. It's Scottish. Mm. That's very good. We binged that. And Yeah, this one that we started watching last night. Oh, Hollingwood Close.
Is it?
It's another mystery, but a little bit miserable. Mm. And Jim and I were watching it almost like a comedy going, oh, why are they doing that? but we need to finish the last one. But yeah, been enjoying, quite like if you're in New Zealand, obviously it's not going to help if you're anywhere else, but TV On Demand, they've got some good British series on there, so. Mm. Innocent, watched Innocent as well, so that was another British one. Anybody watching this in the UK be like, that was on last year, but it's we're so a little loud. Bit behind. Yeah. That's what I've been, that was it for Reading Corner. Mm-mm.
Nice. Okay, one more thing I wanted to mention.
Yeah, I wonder what that was.
Oh, so we've been going through a bit of a game binge at home. What are they called? Board games and things like that. And a friend sent down to us.
Oh, that was from Shazza.
Yeah. Taco Cat, goat cheese pizza. So if anyone is wanting to get a good game for different ages of kids and something that's easy to play, pick up, put down, all that kind of thing, I fully recommend this game. It is hilarious. It's really easy to pick up, and we've been playing it with anyone who will come. So adults and kids alike, and quite little ones, because it's, you know, it's mainly just pictures on the cards. And it's just, it's so good. It's really quick, really easy, and everyone seems to have fun. I just wanted to really plug that.
How do you play it?
So it's a whole bunch of cards, and if I do that. And basically it's kind of like Snap, and you all have a certain amount of cards, and you've all got to flick, you flick one over each time. But every time a card gets flicked over, it has to, so like if we were playing, if we had a few more, I'd flick over a card and say taco, and you'd flick over a card and say cat. These words have to be said each time a card gets flicked over. So if I flick over my card and I say taco and my card is taco at the same time, everyone has to slap down their hands. And then the person who is last has to grab all of those cards. So the aim of the game is to get rid of all your cards first. And then there's also a couple of random cards in there, like gorilla and groundhog and narwhal, and you have to do certain things. Like if you flick over a gorilla card, everyone has to beat their chest and then slap down, or the narwhal card or groundhog is beating on the ground. So it's just hilarious. It's so funny. And even people who are like, nah, lame card games, we've managed to turn a few people and get them into it. So
cool.
Totally recommend for kids and adults of all ages. Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Cool.
Cute.
Cool.
All right. I think it's time.
It's time.
Bum, 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 bum. Okay, guys. So we've got a couple of giveaways that we need to sort out, because we keep doing this and then
not that successfully.
So our second giveaway that we organised, we have not heard from our winner. So it's been some time now, and we've tried to get in contact with her, but she's not responding. So we decided to redraw that giveaway. So that was way back in 7 months ago, it tells me. Maybe even 8 months ago. And that was to do with, would you like to
be 100 years in the future or 100 years behind?
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember why.
Neither can I. It was 27.
Oh, I think it was something to do with Downton Abbey, was it?
Yeah, it could be.
Maybe not.
Can't remember.
27.
Yeah. Okay, so we're doing the redraw now from all those comments that were commented on that particular.
Let's hope you're still watching. Yeah. Otherwise, we're going to be redrawing this again.
Bloody hell. So, what have you got there? Number out of 27 entries?
14.
14! Number 14, you are the winner. 1, 2, 3. Be with. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14! Tanya Irons, can you hear us? You are the lucky winner.
Come on down.
You commented 7 months ago.
Hope you're still watching, Tanya.
You know, I initially thought 100 years in the past, then realised women would have been locked away for wearing unicorns or having amazing 40th birthday parties. I had a superhero party for my 40th in Invercargill. So, it'd have to be 100 years in the future, because hopefully by then we would all have sorted out our shit. Why did I do that? Because we swear enough. We would have all sorted out our shit, and everyone will be enjoying life with lots of rainbows and sparkly lights and have an infinite supply of gorgeous squishy wool, if only. So, there we go. Tanya Irons. So, you must be localish.
That'll be useful. That'll
be very helpful.
Drop that off, dear.
If you can get a hold of us, please do.
We will put our email address down in the description box.
So please get a hold of us so we can send to you the prize that you have won.
So we have some gorgeous yarn, Revolution Designs,
and Money Toto wool.
Oh yeah, that was a combo. We've got some lovely magnets, some soaky stuff
for washing your handmade hand knits,
some pens and a notebook.
I can't believe this chocolate has lasted that long.
I know, I can leave chocolate.
Oh.
some wool wash.
Yes, it's amazing stuff. I
still washi tape.
Love it.
And some stitch markers. Handmade.
Boom.
And a lovely tin. Sorry, I'm rubbish at this. Anyway, lovely.
Yay!
Yay!
Well done, Tanya.
Get in touch.
We don't know where to send it, so you need
Do get in touch, although this is going to be really boring for drawings again.
I know. We'll get a complex. Oh, yeah. They don't want our stinking bloody gifts then. Fine.
All right, next giveaway. So this was for
That's okay. Sorry.
For our 200th episode, 200th subscriber.
Yay!
Yay! So I think we're actually on 230. How do we do that? That's amazing.
We've not done anything.
For ages.
That's pretty cool. I think. Thanks for coming.
And I haven't mentioned this, but I'll mention this now. If you're new, please, can you subscribe?
Like and subscribe.
And can you like? Because it really helps, and it really helps with our the algorithms.
Because we are so committed to this.
Oh, you can tell how committed we are. We do enjoy doing it. It's just life's just going away. Right.
So,
how many out of 12?
12. Out of 12 comments.
Out of 12, bear with. Eight.
Number eight. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think you should be singing while I'm doing this.
Number generator, number generator.
Okay. Bum. This is Sue Bowskill. I'm terrible at reading. Sorry. Would you say that?
Bowskill.
Yeah. You commented 1 month ago, "Hi ladies, from a still lockdown Auckland, you poor thing, in November. Love your podcast, so chirpy and uplifting." Thank you. You make me laugh. One Lane Bridge was a great series. Yes, it was.
Yes.
I really enjoyed My Life is Murder too. Oh, I must look that up. Look forward to your next drop-in. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. I've missed that comment, Sue.
Yeah, we did. We missed it.
Yeah.
Well, look at you. Aren't you lucky?
Look at you.
That's why you always comment, guys, because you just never know.
There we go.
So coming to you when you get in contact with us is a huge, a bumper giveaway. I didn't bring it with me, sorry, guys. But I can talk you through it. Or go on over to the last podcast and you'll see I do show it then.
Mm-hmm.
But that was that lovely handmade project bag from Sue.
Mm.
There were, I think, two star striping balls of sock yarn with some contrast colours for the heels, toes, cuffs. There was an amazing, beautiful tumbler, ceramic tumbler made by Bluffett Ceramics.
Nice.
And I think there was some other little bits, maybe some chocolates and things like that, that were going to get thrown in there too. I feel like there was something else, but I can't quite remember. But yes, that's a great, I think both of those giveaways are amazing. yeah, we kind of wanted to keep them ourselves, but we're not going to.
No.
So please get a hold of us, Sue and Tania. And like we said, we'll put the email address. Email. Or you can just comment.
Or Insta.
Insta, yeah.
Insta.
Yeah, you can totally Insta message us. Message
on
yeah.
Insta. Because we're on Insta we are...
Yeah, it's from the cellar. Yeah. Surprise. But we might try... I don't know if we can, but we might try and put a link to our Instagram account on the...
And on Insta, we could also put the names of
yes,
the people.
Yes, yes. We will, yeah.
We really want you guys to get these.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Cool.
Cool. Awesome.
All right.
I think we've done it.
I think we made it. We've made 45 everybody.
45 minutes in. Thank you so much if you've stuck around to the end.
Yeah.
I feel like that was a bit of a leathery one, but, you know, most of them are.
Yeah. And I think people often like, I like them.
The blethering.
Yeah. And the chatting.
Oh, do you know what? I forgot to mention, and maybe it's too late now, but when we're talking about what we've been watching, I watched over the Christmas period.
Oh,
I love it. All the Vlogmases that are out there, and in particular, I watched Ellie. This Little Wonderful Life.
Yes.
Oh, she's so good. But she often apologizes for waffling on. But and always in the comments, there's so many people who say, "No, we love your waffle," and I love her waffle. So maybe hopefully somebody out there loves our waffle.
Yeah, I loved Vlogmas. I was like really obsessed with it. Yeah.
Watched Stranded Dye Works. Oh, Jude from is living in Scotland. And Sandy by the Lakeside, who's in Canada.
Yeah, I watched Back to Blighty. I got into her and Tales from Cuckoo Land. Really loved her.
Yeah.
As well as Ali. So. Yeah. Really enjoyed. It. Yeah, loved Blockbuster.
Mm. Oh, yeah. Cool.
All right, we better go because this will have used up a lot of your time.
Thank you again.
Like and subscribe. Share with your friends. Only with nice people.
And hopefully... leave us a comment if you are enjoying us. And only nice comments though. Don't leave us a nasty one or else we're not going to read it. So yeah.
No. And we just do this for fun.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
And we won't leave it as long.
Promise. I know that we said that last time. I think.
But we will. We're fresh new year. We're feeling energized. Not completely. No, not really.
But new year, new us. Yeah, we can do this.
Yeah, we can do this. All right. Thank you so much. Love you all.
Bye.
Hope all take care.
Bye, cat.